Hey, my name's Kelly. I process photos for families and so forth. I'm a small business owner. I've discovered an annoying problem with Photoshop. Normally, I'm working on a job that's comprises about 8,000 photographs or more, maybe a little more, probably 8,100, 8,200 possibly. And what I want to do is I want to make sure that my images, my documents are opened in tabs because it makes it easy to work on, and I'll show you why. Here's the problem with Photoshop. Okay, now if you open Photoshop, I'm going to open all these photographs. There's going to be this whole row. I'm going to crop all these little pictures out and save them as individual pictures. Now if you notice these numbers, book 32, book 33, book 34, that is the book that was scanned into folder 46, and 32 is the page, 33 is the page, 34 is the page. Each page comprises however many photographs you see on that page in this demonstration right here. So I want to open these, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to select these photographs and save them as individual photographs. But I need them to be processed in the same order that they are in the book, okay? So that when the customer goes to, they're all going to be saved to an hard drive, to three hard drives. And when the customer goes to a certain photograph in that hard drive, I want them to be able to know that there's this photo before it and this photo after it. So they don't have to go searching through the book to find the photographs in the order that they are on the hard drive. They will all correlate, they'll all be in exactly the same place. They won't be on pages, but they'll be in exactly the same place as far as numbered and in succession in the hard drive compared to the book. They'll be relative as it is. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to open all these. Now, like I said, I was in Photoshop here. Go up to Photoshop, and I want them all to be in tabs because tabs are really easy to work on. So I'm going to open documents as tabs. Now, here's the problem. Now, these open. And it's going to take a minute to open them because there's a lot of them. And I open them in Camera Raw so that it gives this little mark. When I finish this row, I'll come back to the bridge to open the next row, and it won't have any marks, so I'll know it's next. It's kind of a bookmark is what it is. Okay, let's open these. They'll open into Camera Raw, as I said. Let them all fill in for a second here. You can go ahead and select all and open them. It won't. There's no damage that can be done. It doesn't corrupt the files or anything. So I'm going to open images. Now they'll all open in tabs. This takes a little bit of time. What the issue is after they open, the furthest into the book will be the book or the tab that will be the first to process. And I don't want that. I want the first to process to be over here. And these go up to 41. So now what I have to do is I have to click this. Okay, then I process these photographs, and here's how they get processed. I'll show you real quickly. I'm only going to do one because they take too much time to mess around with. And okay, I'm going to go to the ruler tool because this is how we straighten them. We're going to size these so that they can be printed later on. These are all 6x4s. Okay, we go to straighten layer. Wait for this to straighten. Grab the marquee. Select it. Control or Command C to copy it. Control Command N to open a new document dialog. Hit Return or Enter. Now you notice that it's in a tab. I really don't want it to be in a tab, but I want the sources to be in the tabs. Okay, so I'm going to go Command V, Control V to paste. Now I'm ready to work on this image. I'll take these little hairs out, a couple of other things. But I really don't want it to be in this tab. I want it to be in a document. Now, I can drag it out of the tab bar, which isn't so hard. Take these hairs out. All these little distracting marks. Even though they're imperfections, they're more distracting than anything. Okay, now I don't want this to be in the tab. I want it to be in a document. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to auto level this so that it makes it pretty. Take that yellow and pink out. Then I'm going to size it to the size I want for printing later on, which is 6 inches by, this is almost 4 inches, which is fine. Then I'm going to size it to 100 pixels per inch, so it's down to about the size it should be on a Windows machine. Now you notice that, okay, it's all processed. It's all done. Now I'm going to hit Command S to save it. I'm going to save it as the next photograph in the folder, 64. I'm going to save it as a PNG, which is a high resolution, no compression, high resolution file format. Okay, don't save. Okay, now I'm done. Now I'm going to just go ahead and close this. Let's say I'm going to say that I've already processed this photograph here. Now here's the problem. When I close this, I want this to be the next photograph highlighted, the next document highlighted. But it's going to send me over to here. So I close this. I don't save. Now I'm back at 41, and I don't want to be at 41. I want to be at 33. Now, when you're processing as many photographs as I am, and it happens to default to the oldest document, you can process this by accident, and then it'll document, or it'll process this and then this, and it'll be all backwards. You'll end up being out of alignment with what is in the book. Okay, so here's the issue. Let's just close all these. You don't want to save any changes. Go back to Photoshop Preferences, go to Interface, turn off Open Documents as Tabs. Now I'll show you how to open documents as tabs, but not from that menu. Okay, I'm going to go back in here. Now I processed this one photograph. I'm going to go back in here and take that out of there. Okay, go back here. And as I said, they bookmark, so I know where I am. In this case, it's kind of irrelevant because I've already opened them once. So I'm going to open them again. I'll go to Camera Raw and go through that same process all over again. Select all, and you can open images as soon as you want to, as long as you haven't made any changes. Now notice they're all opening as individual and separate documents. But I still want them in tabs. But what I don't want is I don't want them to be available in the wrong order. I don't really want to keep track of them. I want the application, Photoshop, to keep track of them for me. And I'll show you how to get around that. There we go. Now, I've got all those same photographs open again, but they're in documents. I want them in tabs, but I also want them to progress from the left to the right. I don't want to have to keep going from that last one all the way to the first one, and then the last one to the first one again. So we touch the very first one that opened. Remember this one? We touch the first one that opened. Go to Window, Arrange, Consolidate all the tabs. Now you notice that it's open on the left side. It's open exactly the way it should be. Now if I process this photograph, I'll go through this real quickly. Just like I did before. Notice how that's easy to manipulate while it's in a doc or in a tab. I'll straighten this photograph. The ruler tool and do this all over again. Takes a second or two. Okay, hit the select marquee, rectangular marquee. Drag it out. Copy. New, paste, or enter and paste. Okay, let's add the auto levels. Go back in here and take all these little marks out. Get rid of this stuff. Pretty up the sky a little bit. Take all these hairs and so forth out. I believe these were shot in Colorado. Back 1995, I think, is what the year was. Okay, now we're pretty clean. This is good. Okay, now we're going to resize it so that it's at a print size, which is 4x6. So we hit Command Option or Control Option, Control Alt I, and we go in here and we size this to 6 and to 100. We hit OK, my picture sizes, and we hit Command or Control S to save it. 64 PNG, no compression, And we don't want to save it. Don't save. Okay, now let's say that we've done this one and then we've done this one too. Now we're processed. We're ready to go ahead and close this. Now the object of this is to show you that this one will be the next one to open, not here. Don't save. And there we are, 33. The next one in line. And as you go down this line, you process all of these photographs, then these next photographs, you'll notice that they all process exactly in the order that you want them to, just like they are in the book. Photoshop, fix that. Please fix that. Okay. I don't know why. I don't know why Photoshop does that. But, you know, this will keep track of your photographs for you as you work on them. I don't know why they do that, but that's what happens. So, thanks for looking. I'd go over it again, but I don't have the time. Thanks for looking. Just rewatch this. Take it easy. Thanks from Kelly.